Hello and welcome to week one of the Sustainable Energy MOOC. This week we will be taking a look at the basics of energy use and energy conversion. First, let us take a moment to think about the word itself, energy. What comes to mind when you think about energy? This seems like a simple question, but when I ask this to my students, they realize the answer is not straightforward. A cascading waterfall thundering down from a great height has a lot of energy. Coal, found deep under the earth, contains energy. A helicopter needs a lot of energy to stay up in the sky. What do you do when you need energy? Eat, of course. Does the food that we eat have the same energy that is found in the coal mine or embodied by a waterfall? How do we compare these seemingly different kinds of energies? To understand and compare the different forms of energy that we see around us, it is important to be able to define and quantify energy. Energy is often described as the ability of a system to do work. This definition, however, is related to mechanical form of energy. The unit of energy is the joule, is also related to mechanical energy. Let's consider this cup of water. This cup of water has mass of about 100 grams or 0.1 kilograms. Here, on planet Earth, this cup experiences a gravitational force, which is the mass times the gravity constant of approximately 10 meters per square second. This results in a gravitational force of 1 newton on this cup. Now, I lift this cup up by 1 meter. The total energy needed for this action is exactly 1 joule, by definition, which is 1 meter multiplied by a force of 1 newton. 1 joule is defined as the amount of energy required to move an object by a distance of 1 meter against a force of 1 newton. Mathematically, 1 joule is equal to 1 newton meter of energy. 1 joule of energy is too small to be able to quantify the energy that we encounter in our daily lives. In energy analysis, you would normally encounter higher orders of magnitude, such as the kilojoule and the megajoule. The scale on the left-hand side of the screen shows the joule in increasing orders of magnitude with steps of thousands. This is similar to 1 kilogram being equal to 1,000 grams. To put all the different orders of magnitude into a context which we can relate to, we will now define the human unit. This will help us to compare energy at a more personal level, my personal body energy consumption. The average person requires about 10.46 megajoules of energy in the form of food every day to stay healthy and function normally. We will now refer to this quantity of energy as 1 human unit. 1 human unit of energy is thus equal to an energy of 10.46 megajoules. Now, let us look at the daily energy use that we encounter in our daily lives. For example, a 16-watt lamp requires about 1.4 megajoules of energy if it were kept on for 24 hours. With our new system, this is equal to 0.13 human units. The total consumption of energy of an average person living in Europe is about 411 megajoules a day. This includes the energy used for his transportation, cooking, heating, lighting, and other daily activities. In human units, this is equal to 39.3 times human unit. This means that the average European person consumes almost 40 times the amount of energy required to sustain oneself. This figure naturally depends on standard of living and is different for each person. The consumption of a small bookshop is an order of magnitude higher. The average bookshop consumes over 5,400 megajoules, or 5.5 gigajoules of energy per day. This is the equivalent of 524 human units. Thus, every day, the average bookshop uses enough energy for you to sustain yourself for almost a year and a half. Moving further up the scale, we come to the next order of magnitude. A regular 500 megawatt coal-fired power plant produces over 43,000 megajoules or 43.2 gigajoules daily. This is enough energy for over 4.1 million people to sustain themselves for one day. The next step on the scale is the consumption level of entire countries. The daily energy consumption of the Netherlands, a small but developed country, is more than 8,000 terajoules or 8 petajoules. A country of around 70 million people consumes enough energy every day to meet the daily food energy requirements of 783 million people. Finally, the daily energy consumption of the entire world is approximated at over 1,200 petajoules or 1.2 exajoules. This is equal to 180 billion human units. To put this into perspective, the entire human population on the Earth in 2016 is 7.4 billion people. We saw in an earlier slide that the joule, the unit of energy, is defined in relation to mechanical energy. However, energy has several different forms, and the definition of energy changes with each form. Consequently, industries which deal with a particular form of energy use a different unit corresponding to that particular definition of energy. Thermal energy is defined by the energy required to raise the temperature of water. The unit of thermal energy is the calorie, which is equal to 4.184 joules. The chemical energy contained in food is much larger than a calorie. The food industry therefore uses a higher order of magnitude, the kilocalorie. The kilocalorie is also sometimes just called calorie, but written with a capital C. Electrical energy is measured in kilowatt hours. Each kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 megajoules. Let's make it personal again. Remember the human unit we just discussed. Each unit is equal to 2,500 kilocalories or 2.9 kilowatt hours, which is the daily food energy requirement of the average person. From this point on, whenever possible, the kilowatt hour will be used as the unit of energy in this course. The oil and gas industry deals with much larger volumes of energy. 1 ton of oil equivalent, abbreviated as TOA, is the equivalent of 41.87 gigajoules. In our terms, 1 ton of oil has an energy equal to 11,600 kilowatt hours. In addition to these, there are some units that had historical significance and are still used in certain parts of the world. One of such units is the British Thermal Unit, or BTU, which is still used in countries like Canada and the United States. It is used to describe the energy content of fuels and heating systems. Power is a term which is often used when talking about the output of machines or processes. Power is defined as the rate at which work is done. It can also be defined as the amount of energy used per unit of time. The unit of power is called the watt, after the famous Scottish engineer James Watt. 1 watt is the amount of power produced when 1 joule of energy is used in 1 second. Mathematically, 1 watt is expressed as 1 joule per second. In the 18th century, draft horses were used by James Watt as a frame of reference to define the power of steam engines. The horsepower is a unit which is still used today to express the power of electrical machines and engines especially in the transportation industry. One horsepower is roughly equal to 746 watts. The electrical appliances that we use in our homes usually have a label with a power rating. The amount of energy used by the appliances depends on the time for which it's used. A lamp rated at a 40 watt, if used for 8 hours, will use 40 watts multiplied by 8 hours, which is equal to 320 watt hours or 0.32 kilowatt hours of energy. On your electricity bill, the electrical energy usage is expressed in kilowatt hours. You can easily calculate the energy used by other home appliances by looking at their power rating on the label and multiplying by that the number of hours for which the appliance has been used. This is a fun exercise to do. Can you estimate the amount of energy consumed on an average day in your house by filling up a similar table?